Mr. Joe Fierro. I've trained for roughly 16 years, been in racing 25, 26 years. Trained lots of national hunt horses, listed winners on the flat. We're only a small yard, 18 boxes. We've just recently moved to this location. Only a mile away from our old location, most of it is still the same facilities that we've always had, except that we're actually on site 24 hours a day now, which is obviously good for the particular industry that we're in. The product that we've been using that you supply works extremely well both for foals, mares, race horses. It was used on Just Beth when she won at Cheltenham. Horses like Silver Gift that won 5, Marsh Marigold that won 9. And we found it does exactly what it says on the box, basically. No more, no less. And used correctly, it's a good supplement.
Do you sprinkle it over that?
We all do the same. We'll get a bucket. In actual fact, if I show it, it's very simple. We'll get a bucket. Take the scoop. Very simple. Apply it. Mix it well with the feed. Horses can't taste it. We've never had an horse yet that's rejected it. Replace it over. And a simple spread of the hand. Job done.
Yeah.
And put it into the horse's bowl.
Yeah.
It has no taste at all to it, so the horse consumes everything. Doesn't matter what you feed, we've never had any horse in all the period of time that we're using it rejected.
Yeah. And what did you find from once you've gone onto this, what did you find from the horse's return? In other words, what did you spot as a trainer?
Well, I spotted the most obvious things that, as I said to you before, the actual literature that's supplied doesn't lie, really. It showed a glossy coat, it showed an incredibly bright eye, it showed the drop-ins reasonably solid, as you'd like them, and consistent. But those are the main attributes. And as I said before, after work, once you've got into a work program and you start exercising your horses to the point of preparing them for a race, we found the recovery rate satisfactory. They tend to recover and perform quite well.
And what about bleeding, nose bleeding, and lung?
We found it doesn't cure it permanently. But it makes an hell of a contribution. We've been able to race horses that haven't bled, that were bleeders. Bleeding comes in all sorts of forms, really. They can bleed from the lungs, they can bleed from the odd small vessel, they can bleed through a virus, they can bleed through various things. But the particular horses that we used it on, it stopped permanently. There was just a show of slight light blood in the mucus on occasion, but other than that, considering this, the two are permanent bleeders, it obviously has a good effect. An effect that I think most trainers would be pleased with. It does need to be used for at least a month.
Yeah, before you saw anything.
Before you saw the results that the tests have shown to be accurate. And as I've said before, what it says in the test is exactly what it does. It does no more, no less. And I'd certainly recommend it. From the worming point of view, we haven't wormed an horse for almost two seasons. So it does. There's a considerable amount of money saved there. And most horses have been running respectably. So.
Is there anything noticeable in the sort of joint action or the fatigue in the horse?
Difficult, really, because all we've really monitored is the recovery rate.
Yeah.
You'll normally find horses that are on different sort of substances or on nothing. They just take a they do take. They'll sort of they're overbreathers for much more time than if they were on this product.
Mm.
They'll normally every horse obviously comes under beer pressure, but they recover quite quickly with this stuff.
Mm.
We've noticed that's in a significant way, to be honest. But as I said, it does basically what it says on the tin, if you like, and that's the pleasing thing about it.
Mm.
And I think it's a decent product.
Mm.